Your Excellencies, dear guests, on behalf of the Italian Ministry of Foreign Affairs and International Cooperation, I would like to congratulate the Republic of Angola, the African Union and the UNESCO for organizing the second Biennale of Luanda. This event represents a precious opportunity to reflect on the promotion of a culture of peace and non-violence in Africa. Too many conflicts still severely affect the life of millions of people in the continent, while the COVID-19 pandemic has increased the risk of instability by deepening global cleavages and inequalities. Women and children are the ones who suffer the most in these situations. Italy is strongly committed to strengthening the dialogue between Europe and Africa, and to contributing to achieve the objective of worldwide peace and stability by promoting the fundamental principles of freedom, justice, equality, and solidarity between all human beings. Our strategic attention to Africa is clearly demonstrated by our multilateral agenda in this extremely significant year, during which Italy has held the G20 presidency, hosted the third Italy-Africa ministerial conference named Encounters with Africa, and has partnered with UK for the COP26. Let me recall that one of the working sessions of the G20 Foreign Affairs Ministerial meeting held on June 29 in Matera was dedicated to Africa with a focus on climate, fight against the pandemic and economic integration. The Matera Declaration, adopted on the occasion, reaffirmed the commitment of the international community to fight against food insecurity with specific reference to the situation in Africa. Within this context, Encounters with Africa, building on the Italian G20 priorities, People, Planet, Prosperity, offered a further opportunity to focus on environmental and energy issues, the ultimate aim being to contribute to the sustainable and inclusive growth of the continent, keeping in mind the objectives of the African Union Agenda 2063 and the Sustainable Development Goals. Despite the complexity of the tasks ahead of us, we are confident that our cooperation will lead to a future of stability, sustainable development, peace and prosperity for our peoples. Thank you.